Hey, this is Josh from JoshBuilds, and today I'm going to be building a hoverboard. To start the build off, I grab a small bicycle and take it to use the wheels. Once I have the wheels off, I start by building the base. I use a thin piece of plywood, and I'll be cutting two of these out. Here I trace my second one and cut it out. Once that's done, I'm going to trace around the battery I'll be using. You can use a battery smaller than this. I found this was a little large, and I cut out a square. Now I use a thicker piece of plywood and cut that one out too. And in the end I have three pieces of plywood, same shape. Now I start to build the frame. I drill some holes in the piece of wood, just big enough to fit the wheel inside. Now I put some epoxy inside. And be sure to mix the epoxy for 1 minute, I forgot to do that. And then screw the wheels in. Now I'm going to start gluing together the frame. I'll glue the wheel assembly onto the piece of plywood with the square cut out of it, and then clamp that down to dry, and then add a couple more pieces of wood for structure. Now I put a screw on each side just to hold it all together. Now I'm going to assemble the top of it. For that I build a structure just to mount this top part higher than the battery. And you can disregard the motor drive assembly there. I end up taking that off, we don't use that at all. Now the top piece that I glued in is the one that had the wheels. I just took the wheels off to make it easier to work with. Now I get a small rotating wheel and screw it into a small piece of wood. This is going to be a back wheel to help give us stability. Now once I put the big wheels back in, you can see what it looks like. And this will be the main frame of the hoverboard. And this is it with the top. The top would be the thicker piece of plywood. Next is the drive system. I use two small motors and I drill holes in the top for mounting. And as you can see, a clothes hanger fits through perfectly. I also have these rubber wheels that I put a hole in. And essentially what I'm going to do is put the clothes hanger through the wheel and then onto the motor. And do that for both wheels. I apply epoxy, make sure to mix it to hold it all together, and I do that for both wheels. Now this is going to be the bracket that holds the motor. I built a small wooden thing sticking off the back just to hold the bracket, and you can see it's wired right now, but I'll show you how to wire it later. And now I mount the brackets. And I just attached the motor to the bracket with duct tape. I found glue didn't hold very well. Duct tape was the best thing. And on top of the rubber wheels, I just put a disposable red wheel, just so my rubber wheels don't burn away. Now I'm wiring the hoverboard, and it's a little complicated, so you'll see a picture at the end. I also use two normal house switches to turn it on and off. And when I test the wheels, you can see that they work properly. That's our wiring diagram. Now I'm going to put the top on and screw it in. The wooden pieces sticking off the end are used to keep pressure between the wheel and the motor. And now you can see our test. Thanks for watching to the end of my video. Feel free to like and subscribe and check out ways to support me to help me make more cool and better videos like this one. To see my other projects and buy parts you might need, you can check out my channel or my website joshbuilds.com. You can also follow me on my social networks to keep updated with my new content. Thanks.